project delays are often inevitable. And when they occur, we do have a tendency of dragging out certain tasks to where the actual delay occurs. But in this video, I'm going to show you a nice little method that can better demonstrate where the delays occurred, what caused them, and give you a much better reporting tool for future projects. Let's take a look. So for this example, we're going to show a delay occurring after task 18, arranging for road closure. And we're going to assume that the arrangements for this road closure has been held up due to administrative issues. So we're going to insert a new task here, and we're going to include that now. Okay, now we've added that in. Now we're going to have this delay occurring between these two tasks to make it appear in our Gantt charts. So we select those three, and then go and click the link. There you have it. And we're going to assume it's going to take us 5 days of delays. So you can see it has consequences for the entire project. Now it'd be good, wouldn't it, if we could make this stand out, particularly our bar stand. Now how can we do that? Well, we can assign a flag show delays. So we're going to go and just select, for this example, flag 1, and we're going to rename that delay. Do this by right-clicking on the column and selecting field settings, and we'll call the title of it delay. Now we give this a tick of yes to show that it's a delay. Now this differentiates the delay from the other tasks. Now it would be good if we can make this task stand out on the bar charts, and we can do that through bar styles. So we right click on our Gantt chart and we click bar styles, and what we'll do, we'll actually go to the bottom of this sheet and we'll insert our new details here. So we'll call this special bar delay overlay. It gives us a default appearance. Now we're going to have this as normal, active, flag 1, and not manually scheduled. So I'll add those criteria to the show for tasks column. Now that we've got those details inserted in the show for tasks, we might adjust our appearance to make it stand out on the sheet. So we'll change the fill color from a dark, maybe something that stands out like a yellow, and then we'll click OK. And there you have it. You can see that our delay now corresponds to a yellow bar. Now, I'm just going to go through and add a few extra delays to see how well we can go about reporting these delays. So I've added a couple of extra delays. We had our original one around the delay from the council regarding the traffic closure. We also have some bad weather, which delayed the removal of road barriers, and also some photographer delays too in getting those pictures to us. Now, wouldn't it be good if we can also demonstrate the cost involved in some of these delays? Now you can see, just for example, we have John working mostly on this project. Now, a lot of the times we'll be able to reallocate resources elsewhere as a project manager to other projects, but sometimes we can't. We might be involved in a large project where we have machinery and plant on site and they can't be redeployed elsewhere. So the cost is that those sorts of resources remain idle, which is a cost of the project. So hypothetically, we'll also add the same resources, for simplicity's sake, to this project. Now that those resources have been added, we can now go through and filter all of the delays in this project. So let's click on yes. And there we have our three delays shown there. Now, we can also now go in and work out the cost of those delays by choosing the cost column. And now we've got a pretty strong idea on how much these delays have cost us throughout the project. Now, to make this a little simple to digest, we can go to our Gantt chart format tab, remove our summary tasks, and there you have a nice little report that could show you how much the delays cost in this project. So in this case, 1,000 plus 400 plus 600 equals $2,000. So it's an excellent tool for project managers to get in there and highlight the costs caused by delays of a project, but also can be useful when planning other projects into the future in terms of quantifying risks and understanding the cost of certain issues. Now, before we leave, there's one more useful thing to think about in applying this method that can be of use. Say, for example, we are anticipating a delay from council, but the delay hasn't yet occurred, but we're putting it into our project because we think it's almost certain that it's going to occur. But then we learn that it's not going to occur. What you can do is you can go to your task and then click inactivate, and that will inactivate the delay and remove it from the project. Now, if it does eventuate, we can reactivate it by clicking inactivate again, and it also appears. So a useful tool for managing projects and its inevitable project delays. Thank you for listening to Performance with Project. We'd love to hear from you again. Please subscribe, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.